Hello traders, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I recently made a video about my settings for my volume profiles for intraday or day trading using the session profile on lower time frames in TradingView. In this video, I'm gonna talk to you about the settings that I use for longer term volume profiles that I would use for a higher time frame analysis or for swing trading here on TradingView. Okay, so this can be applied to any market. You know, right here, this is a Bitcoin chart. I'll just show you like an example in crypto, and then we'll go into a futures chart as well. But for my higher time frames, if you go into indicators, technicals, profiles, this is all the preset indicators you have for volume profiles. Now, I showed you how for day trading, I like to use the regular session volume profile. You know, if you want to have a periodic profile, they have this new one called auto anchored. And I have a video about this on my channel as well. This is basically where you can apply a daily profile, a weekly or a monthly, quarterly, etc. Just a profile that repeats every certain period. Okay. But for swing trading, I like to use a fixed range volume profile, but we are not going to be using this. I do not like this one. Because if you select this profile, what's gonna happen, let me select it just to show you, and I apply it here, we get the profile, but then if I go and I change markets and I go, let's say, into Ethereum, you can see I now get the same profile on the same placement, meaning it starts on the same date and time on whatever market I change to. This is no use to me because when I'm using a fixed range profile, I have very specific strategic anchors that I'm going to use depending on what market I am going to be analyzing. So in that case, instead of using one of the indicators, the tool that I like to use is the volume profile drawing tool, which you can find. Where is it? Right here on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the 7th icon here. If you go into the pull down menu, right here, fixed range volume profile. This is going to be a tool that is going to let you just select it and pretty much just fix it to wherever you want. So on this Bitcoin chart, you can see we're over here right now. So when I apply a longer term volume profile, I want to catch a big price rotation like we have right here. Plus, we also have a lot of confluence right here of a lot of volume buildup. So I know there's going to be a high volume node here. So I also want to cover this area in case we push up here. This is going to be a very important level coming into this consolidation. So if I zoom out, then let's say I'm going to just take this. And I'm going to hinge my profile. Let's put it right over here, pretty much from the all-time high right here. So I just go here. I select fixed range. I'll click the all-time high, drag it, release. And you can see now I have a profile here. You know, I could even drag it forward because obviously this whole area right here is very far away. This is more interesting for me right now. So I could potentially, so I don't have to zoom out so much, I could even just drag this here and let's just put it right here. Okay. So we can have a closer profile. So If you're putting this on your platform, it might look different because this is just based on the default that I have set, but I'll show you all the settings that I use on this. So first thing I like to do, you can see that this is covering the candles. So I like to right click on it, visual order, and I put sent to back. That way it's going to push the profile behind the candles, so it's not covering anything on my chart. And now as far as the settings, let's double click it. And this is going to bring up the settings. So we're going to go one by one here. Visibility, usually depends what time frame I'm using. If I'm on a daily chart, I will want to show it on a daily and an hourly chart. And again, we're talking about swing trading, so we're probably not going to be going down into like minute time frames. We're probably going to use it on the higher time frames, like a daily, a 4 hour, 12 hour, etc. So I like to just mark off days and hours. Coordinates, this doesn't matter. This is basically just telling you where you have your hinges right here for the profile. Style, you got to have falling profile enabled, otherwise it just disappears. Width box percentage, this depends. This is basically how far out you want it to stick. I generally like to use 50% as a good middle ground. Placement, I always have it on the left. This is a big issue that I would like TradingView to finally address this, because if I put right, you can see it's going to stick the profile right here where price is at the moment. For me, you know, that is not really useful, because it's kind of bothers me that it's right here. I would like to have it here. The visible range indicator is able to put it here, but the problem with the visible range is it's a dynamic profile. So wherever you move the chart, the profile is going to be changing shape. So I like to use a fixed range. So in that case, like I said, for the moment, TradingView does not have an option to put this on the far right. So I just like to have it on the left side of the chart right here. As you notice, in my case, when I'm swing trading, I don't really care to highlight the value area, high, low, or point of control. So what I do is I just put the exact same color on the value area and the up and down volumes. In this case, I like to use gray. So I just have a medium gray color, something that contrasts well with the background, so I can see all the edges of my high volume notes very well. And you can see everything else is off. Histogram box, this is if you want to apply some kind of background to your profile. I don't like to use that, so I always have it all the way to zero, the opacity. And now the inputs. As I mentioned in the other video, if I am using a profile on a crypto or a Forex market, I like to use on the layout, I like to use number of rows. And generally, I like to use a very high number so that I get a very high definition on this. Because if I put like 100, you can see that it looks very chunky. I like to be able to see the edges very well. So I just like to put a high number, like 1,000. But again, there's no set rule on this. You can play around with this number to see what you like. I just like to have it look very sharp on the edges. Volume, I like to use always total volume. And value area, I always use 68. The extend right, this is actually a function they recently added, which has been really, really great, because before this existed, if you put a profile from here to here, let's say that this was, we were right here in November, then market would continue every day, but the profile was just stuck here. With this option, if you market, the profile is going to keep moving. Every time you print a new candle, the profile is going to be taken into account, all those new values, all the way to the current price on the chart, okay? If you want to just analyze a section of a chart, then disable this, and then you can just select your pivots to wherever you want. But I always use the extend right, just because I want to take into account all prices all the way to the present. Okay. And that's pretty much the settings that I use. I mean, this is pretty basic. I use this on any market. Well, like I said, this is in Bitcoin. Let's go into a Forex chart. Like, let's say here, this is a Euro US dollar chart. And so you can see right here, for example, we've had this big leg down and now we're coming back up. So since I'm right here, I care about the confluence that we have with this past price action right here. So then this swing high would be a nice area for me to hinge a profile from. So I just go right here, I select fixed range, click, you can even release it anywhere, and it's gonna go all the way to the end because we have the extend right setting filled in. I right click, visual order, send to back, right there. And there we have the profile. And again, same thing. I'm using the numbers layout. I got 1,000, which is a nice setting to use on higher time frame charts. Total volume 68. I do not have the value area and everything laid out, but obviously you can use that if you want to. And that's pretty much the default I use on Forex for my swing trading analysis. And from there, you know, you can watch my weekly analysis videos. I go over this a lot in detail on my courses as well. But what I like to see is I like to analyze the high volume nodes, and I pay attention to this cuts in volumes, because these areas where volumes go down are areas that are support and resistance, as you can see right here. All these areas where you have bid cuts here, they're areas where price exhibits big turning points, like support and resistance level areas, etc., as you can see right here. Okay, and you can see all this in my volume profile videos on the channel. I'm not going to go into detail on strategies because I'm just showing you the settings that I use. And then finally, if we go into a futures market, let's say we go into ES, into the S&P 500, you know, in this case, you can see we've been moving pretty tightly around this area. So there's probably a big point of control right around here. But if I'm going to hinge a profile, I'll probably select, you know, we can probably go right here, like pretty much right around all-time highs again, because that way we cover this whole area. So if we keep pushing up, we have all this confluence to the left right here. So same thing, I'll go select fixed range, go back here, drag it, and right there. Again, I select visual order, send to back. Now with futures, the only difference is that over here on inputs, I like to select ticks per row. And in this case, the lower the tick number, the more precise it is. So if I put one tick, that's going to give me the most precise volume profile. Now you can see, you know, if you use number of rows, it's not wrong. Like I can put number of rows, and let's say I put 1,000, and the profile is going to be very, very similar to the ticks. I like to use ticks per row, one in futures, just because futures market moves in ticks. And so basically what this means is each tick level and price, remember in futures, in the case of ES, 4 ticks equals 1 point. So between every point on the price scale, there's 4 ticks. So we're going to get a row per each tick. So that's going to give us a very precise profile. And so right there, that is pretty much the settings that I use for my higher time frame analysis. And again, like in this case, we have a really big high volume node here. So I pay a lot of attention to the edges of these nodes. Within this, we have some cuts in volume, some areas of interest right here. Like if I extend lines from these levels, you can see that these are significant areas of support and resistance, etc. Okay, but that's pretty much my settings when it comes to swing trading volume profiles on TradingView. Okay, that's pretty much it for the video. Hope you all enjoyed it. Have a great evening, and I will be talking to you on the next video. Make sure to subscribe, check out the video description and the courses, and I'll see you soon.